Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about deciding whether you get one of these or one of these. So you're about to purchase a new iMac and you're scrolling through the options considering different things that you can get with it, and you notice, of course, that you can choose between a Magic Mouse and a Magic Trackpad. And they're the same price, so which one should you get? Now, there are a lot of factors to take into consideration, and your first instinct may be to go with the Magic Mouse because perhaps you've used mice all the time and you don't want to switch. But you should seriously look at the Magic Trackpad as a good alternative. Now, I've got both connected to this Mac right here, and we can go into System Preferences and there's a mouse and trackpad pane. I can go into each one and see some of the gestures and options offered. So I can see, for instance, here for a Magic Mouse that I've got point and click controls for scrolling. You can scroll across the top of the Magic Mouse. You can also secondary click and decide whether or not that's on the right or left side. Since it's just a touch surface, you can basically think of it as a two-button mouse, even though you can actually touch any part of the surface you want. And you can smart zoom, double tap with one finger. You also get more gestures in here where you can swipe between pages, you can swipe between full screen apps, and you can activate mission control. But that's it as far as gestures are concerned on the Magic Mouse. Now, on the Magic Trackpad, you get much more. You've got point and click things and even three-finger drag. You've got scroll and zoom gestures, and you even have this whole section here of more gestures with all sorts of different things you can add. So it's the full set of gestures. This is actually the same set of gestures you would get if you bought a new MacBook Pro, which of course has a trackpad built in. Now, there are other differences as well. Of course, ergonomically they're very different. The mouse is something that you hold in your hand and you need a space on your desk to move around. So you're actually moving your arm as you control the mouse and the cursor on your screen. The Magic Trackpad, on the other hand, stays in the same place on your desk. So you're not actually moving your arm, you're just barely moving your fingers across the top of it. It's the same thing as, I said, the MacBook Pro. So it's a little bit different in the ergonomics there, and also how you use your desktop space. You're going to need maybe some sort of pad or something for the Magic Mouse to be on, depending upon the surface of your desk and what that's like, and just some space to move the mouse on. Whereas the trackpad always stays in exactly one spot and never moves. They both take two AA batteries, and you can use rechargeables in there like the ones that Apple sells. So there's really no advantage or disadvantage for each one over battery power. One thing I really like about using a Magic Trackpad is that it's the same on my MacBook Pro as it is on my desktop Mac. So I don't have to switch pointer devices. I'm not 1 minute using a mouse and the next minute using a trackpad. And also, there are some hints that this is the future. Consider, first of all, that 60% of all Macs sold are laptops. So most Macs actually use a trackpad. And the Magic Trackpad has been fairly successful, and in fact PC manufacturers are now starting to offer it as an option to have a static trackpad that sits next to your keyboard. So it may be that the mouse is on the way out and trackpads are the way of the future. I also find the trackpad to be a little bit more accurate with the way that I use a cursor. So I can just barely brush the top of it and move over a few pixels, whereas with the mouse, since I'm moving the entire device to move the cursor, I find that I can't get quite as much precision. Now, other people may disagree and find the opposite. Now, one thing to note about the Magic Trackpad is it doesn't do something a lot of people think it should do, is that you can't hold it like this and actually click on it. I can actually move my cursor around the screen just fine, but clicking doesn't work. And the reason is because you're actually clicking the surface down, so it needs to be on a flat, hard surface like a desk in order for the clicking motion to work. So for me, the advantages of the Magic Trackpad are many more gestures to choose from, the full set. It's the same as what MacBook Pros use, so it's what a majority of Mac users are using, and it stays at a single spot on your desk and doesn't require you to move your arm around as much. The advantages of the mouse are, if you are used to using a mouse, then this will probably be a better device and you won't have to get used to using something new. So if you ask my opinion, I go with the Magic Trackpad. It's what I use, and I think it has a lot of advantages, and when somebody asks me which one they should get, I say go with the Magic Trackpad. So that's my opinion on choosing between the two. Love to hear your opinion. You can leave a comment on this video at the MacMost website. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now.
Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.